Hi students, coming to the next topic in the subject software engineering was black box testing. So in the previous videos I explained about different types of testings. Now let us see the black box testing. So where we conduct this black box testing? A black box testing is a method of software testing. Okay, it is a method of software testing that examines the functionality of an application. So you have to remember that these points, it only examines the functionality of an application without looking it into its internal structure or working. So the main thing here is a black box testing only examines the application area, only the functionality of an application. It doesn't involve in the matter of what the internal structure will be. Okay, so without looking into the its internal structure or working, that you call it as a black box testing. So the main thing is, whenever you ask you to write about the black box testing, the first thing you have to remember that the black box testing is only examines the functionality of an application, only outer, okay, only the functionality of an application only it will be tested. It doesn't bother about what are the internal structures and what are the working conditions and which type of language they used. So it doesn't bother about that. Only the outside view will be tested. This method is applied at every level of software testing: unit testing, integration testing, system testing, and acceptance testing. So you may get the doubt. I said black box testing is only examines the functionality of an application. It doesn't look into the internal structure, but it is applied to unit and integration. So the unit and integration testing, everything will be done on the coding. Okay, so here the unit testing will be done on the module. It is the smallest module. You can take it as the smallest module. So inside the smallest module, if you want to test the code, that will be done by unit testing. So the smallest module application, okay, that smallest module functionality of an application will be tested by the black box. In the same way for the integration, whenever you are combining all the smallest element into one element, that there you will done the integration testing. So the integration testing will be done internally. What is the, how the code is interacting, is able to communicate all the modules. So here the black box testing will only examines the functionality of an integration testing. Examines the functionality of an integration testing application. So in the way system and acceptance. So the testers are based on requirements and functionality. So here the main testers will be based on requirements and functionality. So it doesn't bother about the internal structure and the code. It only based on the requirements and functionality. Means what is the functionality and what is the requirements? That is the input whatever we are given and the output you are getting and the requirements that we are giving. Okay, and the events that are going to be executed. So it is only focus on these elements. It doesn't bother about what is going on inside. So you are going to test what are the inputs that we are giving. Is it the correct input? And whatever the input we are giving, the output will getting what the customer wants. Means is it matched to the exact output? So that you have to be tested. Based on the input, are you getting the correct output or not? Okay, and the requirements that we are giving is correctly or not, and the events that are going to be executed internally on this application is correct or not. So that will be tested by with the help of black box testing. So it is carried out to test functionality of the program, and you also call as a behavioral testing. So it is the another name for this black box testing is behavioral testing. Means it is testing only on the behavior things like input and the output and the requirements and the functionality events like that. So that's why we call it as a behavioral testing also. So the tester in this case has a set of input values. The tester is nothing but is a person who is going to be tested. Whether it is a customer or whether it is a developer, whatever person he may be. So that person will give the set of input values and the desired results. So first he gives the set of input values and the desired values for that input values. On providing input, if the output matches with the desired result, the program is tested okay. So starting only we will give the set of input values, and for that input values we will get the desired result. So that is the exact procedure. So whenever you so here black box testing is going to test, first it is giving one input value and it is matching the output, whatever that we get based on this input will meet the requirement of the desired result or not. Okay, if it is meet the desired requirement, then the program is correct. If it doesn't meet the requirement, it doesn't meet the desired result, then the program is having some error. Okay, so in that way the black box testing will be used. In this testing method, the design and structure of code are not known to tester, and testing engineering and end users conduct this test on software. So again, as I said that the testing method only concentrate on the design and structure of the code. Design and structure of the code. It doesn't bother about what inside the code. Okay, what it will be there inside the code. And it doesn't test is there any errors in the inside the code. Okay, it's only think about the design and structure of the code are not known to the testers, and the testing engineers and end users conduct this test on software. So this is about the black box testing. Thank you.